when Uncle Matt called and told me about Lila, I had this picture in my head of her. It was so clear. She was laughing with her just beautiful face, with her bun. She was so beautiful. We were on the train ride to Ned and Lois's wedding. And Stone was there holding my hand.
Stone, wow. That was, you know, a while ago.
I thought about him a lot on the plane right here. I mean, not just about how much I loved him, but, you know, what he wanted for me in my life. And for you.
He asked me to take care of you, you know. I haven't done a very good job of that.
I haven't done a good job of letting you. Time passes, though. And I realize that the worst thing in the world is to not say the things that you need to say to the people who matter to you. I just want you to know that I am so sorry for the distance between us. And I love you.
I love you too, sweetheart. And you don't have to apologize for anything. Because as long as you're happy, that's all. Lila or Stone or anybody, you know, me included, could want for you.
Oh, hi.
Hey, guys.
How are you?
Oh, I'm so good. It's so good to see you.
Oh, hi.
Hey.
How are you?
Sorry,
it's
under these
eyes. No, but it's really nice to see you.
Come here. Is there a reason Lucy is wearing red? Well, I'll let Lucy explain.
Oh, what? What am I going to explain?
You are red.
It's actually in honor of Mother Quartermaine.
Lila liked red?
You know, I think she liked all colors, so I'm sure she liked red, too. But boy, she knew how to dress, didn't she? She always had that flair, and she was always beautiful and sparkly, and that's not really the point, is it, though?
Is there a point?
You remember, I was briefly married to Alan, right? I mean, it was a whirlwind courtship, and, well, actually, we probably shouldn't have gotten married ever at all, but we did because I wanted to. I wanted to be a Quartermaine at that time, very desperately, and so I was happy, and so I wanted the best dress ever. I wanted the dress of all dresses, society to be impressed by my style, and when it came, it was red. But it came that day, and I knew if I didn't put that dress on, then maybe the wedding would have to be postponed.
And that would give Alan a chance to come to his senses.
That is not funny. That is really unkind. However, it's sort of a teensy-weensy bit true. I wanted that wedding to go on, and so I made that wedding go on, so I put that dress on, and it was red, and everybody made fun of me, and I was the laughing stock, and everybody laughed except Mother Quartermaine. And she actually said I looked really lovely, and she was very kind, and she said that red was my color, and it complimented me so well. Anyway, that marriage didn't last, did it? And Alan and I didn't part on very friendly terms, but over the years, we made up our differences, and he became one of my very favorite ex-husbands, and I think a lot of that to Mother Quartermaine. She would never admit it, though, you know that.
It sounds like Lila. Mm. Always doing amazing things and making them sound like they happened by accident, right?
Yeah, you're right. Do you know she was actually the only person I think that was always happy to see me? And she also told me that that red wedding dress wedding was her absolute favorite wedding of all time, except for hers, of course. So that's it. That's why I'm wearing red. It is in tribute of Mother Quartermaine, and I don't care if everybody thinks I'm in extremely bad taste, because Mother Quartermaine and I know better.
Robin, it is so good to see you. Thank you for coming.
Of course.
Tracy, you remember Robin? Robert and Anna Scorpio's daughter?
Vaguely.
She flew all the way from Paris to attend Mother's funeral.
Lila was a wonderful woman. I admire her more than I can say.
Thank you. Mr. Corinthos?
Lila was a great lady in the best sense of the word. It was an honor to know her.
What did I tell you? Every mongrel and gutter snipe mother ever took pity on is going to show up here claiming a close personal relationship.
And you're going to smile and welcome them just the way our mother would want you to. Now get in there.
I have missed you. It's been way too long. Tell me about it. Do you know who this is? Oh, Brooklyn. Oh, my goodness. I'm sorry. Hi, I'm Robin Scorpio. I knew you when you were shorter than me.
When I was a baby?
Yeah, I'm sorry. I always hated it when people said that to me.
Well, don't kid yourself. She's still my baby, and you always will be.
Amanda, thank you for coming.
Oh, it was such a privilege to know your mother.
I'm glad you could be here. My grandmother always really liked you.
Well, I really liked your grandmother. And I respected and admired her ability to be so generous with people and accept them without judging them.
Well, there's no question it was a real loss for anyone who ever knew her.
She treasured your friendship, both of you.
Well, she gave so much to us through the years. And she always told those marvelous stories, you know, like when you had to move up over Kelly's.
Monica threw them out. Lila was welcome to stay, but she didn't want to desert Edward, whether or not he deserved it.
Well, she always said that you were totally justified. And she loved having such a strong and intelligent daughter-in-law who stood up for herself. And she was always so grateful to you for letting them stay with you in your home.
Well, Ellen gave me the house. Lila made it a home.
Hey.
Hi. Hello.
I want you to meet somebody. This is Robin. She knew you when you were little.
It's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
I believe I bought your first Halloween costume. You're a pumpkin.
Aw, man.
Don't worry. You looked cool. And look, you're practically all grown up.
He's getting there.
Bet your parents are really proud of you. Oh, and by the way, congratulations, Sonny. Tells me that you had another little boy.
Yeah, Morgan.
Well, you named him after Jason.
That's right. Jason's our best friend.
I know that. And I'm very happy for you guys.
Oh, it's so good to see you.
Good to see you. Red. How original.
My mother would have loved it. She so enjoyed you.
Well, it truly was a mutual admiration society, and I was so very proud to be Lila Quartermaine's daughter-in-law. You're the old one. No, I mean, you're the one that was before and then after me, but I got to be here for a little while.
Yes, well, Lucy, and Kevin, thank you both for being here.
Well, like everyone else, I sure admired Lila. And I think in a professional capacity, she was probably the only truly sane person, including myself, that I've ever met.
Jax?
There you are.
Hey.
Hey, I've missed you. You know, I'm such an idiot for not coming to see you every time I'm in Europe.
Oh. It's okay, you're busy, I'm busy.
Yeah, but I shouldn't be too busy for you. Courtney, this is Robin Scorpio, Courtney.
Hi.
Matthews.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Brenda has told me a lot about you. You're Sunny's sister, right? And Jason's wife.
Oh, actually, we got divorced.
Yeah, now Courtney's free to pursue other interests.
Does other interests mean you?
Well, Courtney's not pursuing me, I'm pursuing her.
Got it.
So I didn't realize that you knew Lila.
No, I never had the opportunity to meet her, but everybody did seem to admire her. Just here out of respect.
Your grandmother was a really wonderful person.
Yeah, it's kind of weird. I guess you guys knew her better than we did, huh?
Yeah. I mean, I don't blame Brooklyn's mom for taking her away or my mom even. I mean, our family is messed up and they had good reasons, but you guys are really lucky.
Yeah.
You missed out on someone special. Hey. How you doing?
Oh, we had a screaming fight at the house. I got everyone's adrenaline pumping.
And we got everybody calmed down and out the door, which isn't easy because it was such a hard group to manage.
What do you mean they? You were in there yelling too?
Don't remind me.
okay. Long, loud, complicated arguments that don't resolve anything are a Quartermaine tradition. And like it or not, you're one of the family.
Your mother gave so much of herself to the hospital. She helped so many people.
Yes, she did, including me. I mean, I would have never made it through some of those endless charity dinners without Lila to talk to.
Our whole family loved her. I wish Luke could be here to tell everybody how much, because I don't have the words, but Lila was magnificent.
Well, I'm sure Lila would say the same thing about Luke. She had a weakness for scoundrels.
Mm. We'll all miss her.
We will, too.
Thank you so much for bringing her memoirs. It means a lot for us to have a permanent record of her life in her own words.
It was an honor to be able to help her tell her story. She was an amazing person, and she loved all of you very much.
You hiding?
Robin.
I'm sorry. I thought someone would have told you that I was coming.
No. I'm glad you're here. Grandmother would appreciate it.
How are you doing?
Fine, you know. Doing good. What about you? How's Paris?
I love it. It's starting to become my home. I see my mom all the time, and Brenda when she's not traveling on business. Yeah. She says hello, no, by the way.
You can tell Brenda I said hi.
Okay.
I guess we should go in.
This is really hard for you, isn't it?
Yeah, I gotta be here. You know, those Quartermaines need me.
It's good that you know that.
It's because of you. I mean, a lot of time that I spent with my grandmother was because you asked. And it made her very happy, and it made me better, so thank you. I owe you more than I can ever repay.
We have come together to celebrate the life of a remarkable woman. Lila Morgan Quartermaine was loved by every person in this building. That's not an exaggeration or a pleasantry. It's a simple statement of fact.
I came into the Quartermaine family many years ago. Quite a formidable group. I have to say, at first, I didn't love most of them. No, I take that back. I didn't like most of them very much at first. Lila was the exception. She was warm, she was gracious, and most of all, she was welcoming from the moment we met.
There are so many superlatives to describe my mother: kind and generous and loving and beautiful. Oh God, was she beautiful. I never met a person who didn't like her, which I understand. But she liked everybody, which I'll never understand. She laughed. She loved with an open heart, and it was returned in kind by her family and her friends. She was the best.
When I was 14 years old, I overheard two friends of my mother trying to figure out. A woman as delightful as Lila Quartermaine could have raised me. A sentiment that I'm sure has been echoed by many people over the years. She always saw the best in me. And when I disappointed her, which happened frequently, she would express her displeasure mildly, And then she would tell me. She loved me anyway. That love has sustained me my whole life. She embodied the elegance of her generation while at the same time rising above them to pursue her own goals. She had faith in herself. She was a unique individual. She never stopped learning. And I, in turn, will honor her by learning from her.
My grandmother was the first person, actually she was the only person, to truly understand that I loved to perform. And I think it's because she was also a performer, very gifted. Because I know there were times when she was too tired or discouraged or just plain fed up to be all that we needed her to be and expected her to be. And that was smiling, serene, wise Lila Quartermaine. She was always there for us, for me, to make things better. She dug deep and found the resources to give us the best of herself. That was her gift. And we are all better for it.
There's nothing that I can say about my grandmother that someone else hasn't already said better. I missed the part of her life where she walked and danced. I met my grandmother when she was in a wheelchair, but her spirit was free. She encouraged me to try things, to take chances. She warned me that I might get hurt along the way, but she guaranteed that it would be worth the trip. She wanted me to find true love, and she said that it had been the sustaining grace of her life. I didn't say goodbye to my grandmother. She was looking out the window of her sitting room, and I waved as I left the house. And I wish now that I'd gone upstairs and kissed her. I wish that I had told her that I loved her, but I know that she knew. Everyone here wants to pay tribute to Lila, and that's how you do it. You tell someone you love them one extra time. You take the extra 30 seconds to go upstairs and make sure they know. Make sure you tell them how much they mean to you.
be true, for there are those that trust me, and I would be pure, for there are those that care, and I would be strong, for there is much to suffer, and I will be brave, for there is much to dare. I will be friend to all the foe and friendless. I will be giving, and I'll forget the gift. I will be humble, for there I know my weakness. I will look up to laugh and love and live.
To join God and all his angels in everlasting life. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
May I thank you all for coming here today. My wife would be so moved by this outpouring of love. She so loved you all in return. I believe there is a heaven. And I believe she's there now. Pleased. Maybe a little embarrassed by all the attention. But I know she understands how deeply she touched us all. And how irreplaceable she is in all our lives.
You.
There are a few kind, sir. Some flirty girls and very pretty too.
Did you hear?
Oh, that's a wonderful idea. And I know exactly what song.
I've grown accustomed to the trace of something in the air, accustomed to her face.
May you find your way in peace. May you.
Well, all I can say, Lila, is wherever I do go, you will always be with me.
May you.